It's a beautiful day in an undisclosed location, and we're making a hot, hot video for you guys right now.
It's in the stories that we say, like someone's waiting to be told. The act encompasses the play. We watch the scenes we live unfold.
What's going on, guys? My name is Ryan Huber. I'm a corporate pilot and flight instructor, and I hope you can hear me well. There's some music, some things going on in the background, but it's a beautiful day, and I thought I'd make a video about a topic that I get asked about a lot as a corporate pilot, and that's, how do I become a private jet pilot? What are the steps that I can do to get into this industry? A lot of people think it's tough to get into, or they're not sure that this is even a realistic alternative to maybe going to the airlines. And I wanted to talk about this from the perspective of someone who has their ratings. Maybe you're a CFI, you're trying to understand where you want to go, what your path is in aviation, or maybe you have zero flight experience and you're trying to find a career, you're in high school, and you're just looking for guidance, and you say, huh, private jet pilot, that could be pretty cool. I just want to talk about what I did and what you can do to make this career a reality. And if you're starting from zero time, the first thing that you can do for free without really any resources is network. And it's so much easier today, I think, than before, because we have so many social networks, so many platforms that we can use to network with people in the industry. And just, you know, start going on your Instagram account and reaching out, DMing people are in this industry and be like, hey, you know, what are you flying? How'd you get into it? Can you recommend any advice? Do the same thing with LinkedIn, with Twitter, Facebook. There's so many Facebook groups that can help you get into corporate aviation. Some of them I can name off the top of my head. Corporate aviation job listings, private jet pilots, along with many, many others that you can use to network with people, find jobs, aviation career mentorship. So look these up and use social networks to your advantage. And that's something you can do for free right off the get-go. And then you're gonna have to go to flight school. If you wanna be a pilot, you're gonna have to go to flight school. And there's a lot of different options for this. I talked about this in a previous video, like going to aviation college. And that's one option if you have the money. It's a great, great program. There's some phenomenal aviation colleges out there, but for most people, I would recommend against that, just because it's a lot of money for your flight ratings, and there's a quicker, more efficient way to do that. And you know, a lot of these programs nowadays are charging somewhere like $200,000 for a four-year bachelor's degree along with your ratings, which is a lot of money. So if you can minimize that cost, what I would recommend doing is, if you can, find a good freelance flight instructor. Look out in your local area. I actually made a Facebook group for this called Arizona Freelance Flight Training. If you're in Arizona, check that out. But look for a freelancer. Look for somebody who's passionate about instructing that maybe can hook you up in a local flight club to get you started in aviation and do your ratings for the best possible price, or even look into buying your own airplane. You can buy a Cessna 150, a Cessna 172 as an investment, and then get your ratings, do all your time in that airplane, and make the most of it, and then sell it, and you're gonna come out with a much lower net cost than it would be to go to a structured 141 flight school, or even like a local mom and pop flight school. So I think that's the best option. If you're getting into aviation, network, go to your local airport, just talk to people. You know, talk to people in the industry, talk to guys with epaulets and bags, and be like, hey, you know, and the most important tip I can give is offer value. If you can offer value to pilots in any way possible, be like, look, I'll clean your airplanes, I'll help you, is there anything I can do for you? Because if you give value to someone, they're more than likely gonna give value back. And you shouldn't be seeking that, but the more value you can provide into the industry from the get-go, the faster and the more you're gonna grow. And you're gonna meet people, and you're gonna collaborate, and people are gonna help you if you help people. So network, add value in any way you can. I know it is difficult being an absolute beginner, but look for opportunities to do flight training for the cheapest cost. Make it serious, take it very seriously, and go fast, which would lead me into, if you can't find a freelance flight instructor, or someone who's can do it at a really reduced cost, or maybe invest in an airplane with some kind of capital or figure something out, then go to, what I did was an accelerated flight school. I went to ATP flight school. I have some videos on that. There's some other programs, big flight schools that offer accelerated track programs where you can take out a loan, get financing, or even pay up front and get all your ratings done in a short amount of time. And I think that's the best option. Time is the one asset you can't get back. Money, you can. You can always make more money, but you can't make more time. And the quicker you can get into this industry, the quicker you can get your ratings, it's gonna work out much, much better for you. And then for you people that might have your ratings and you're like, hey, you know, I don't know if this is a good alternative to the airlines, or, you know, what do I want to do with my CFI, all these ratings? I've got this career path, but where do I want to take it? I'd ask you, you know, what motivates you? What do you want out of this experience? I think the airlines are amazing. There's so many opportunities right now in the airlines, but it's way more structured and there's a lot more stability, which are good things for some people. But I think there's an amazing, amazing, unique experiences that you get out of corporate aviation that are unmatched and you can't replicate in the airlines or some other job opportunity. The ability to associate with people with a lot of wealth, with a lot of power, and get that kind of drive and that vibe from them. I really enjoy being able to have a close customer service relationship with high-end individuals and private clients to really grow myself and change my mindset. And then also give an amazing experience to them and do some things and go to some places that you could only dream of. I'm in a place right now that's absolutely beautiful, just one of the most beautiful places on earth. And I can't talk about it too much because, you know, I have a private relationship with what I do with my clients, and I can't disclose too much information. But I'll tell you, if you're more of a risk taker and you're willing to take more risks and work for more of a small dynamic company than a large corporation, and you want to have some fun, you want some unique experiences, this industry is amazing and it's changed my life, and I've done things that I'm just so blessed to be in the position that I'm in and do some amazing things. And for you people that are making that decision, it's easier than you think. You know, go and network around your FBO, go talk to pilots, talk to people, and just introduce yourself. And the more you can put yourself out there, the more you're gonna get back. One thing I did starting out when I was a CFI is I would take my resume, I would dress up pretty nice, and I'd go out and I'd give my resume to people and just introduce myself. Hey, you know, I see you have a charter company, I'm low time, I don't have that many hours, but, you know, here's my resume. I'd love to network with you and work for you maybe in the future. If you need an asset in the future and I can help you, I'd love to help. You know, you're not going to get anything bad out of introducing yourself and trying to provide value to people and value to companies. And, you know, do that. And then network on Facebook, provide value to people, network on Instagram, talk to people, reach out. And then along with that, there's some great resources just online. Climb2350.com, business, aviation business jobs. I'll leave it in the description. I forget the name of the website. But there's a lot of different websites too where you can find jobs. And I'm telling you, it's an amazing industry. It's not for everyone. There's some fundamental differences between choosing the airlines and choosing the corporate aviation lifestyle. This job is more risky. there's not as much job security. It's a smaller company. You're working for maybe a family or doing charter for different individuals who charter airplanes and rent out private jets. But it's way more niche, but especially being young, it's a lot of fun. It creates some incredible, incredible memories, and it's something that I'm really, really proud of and really blessed to be a part of. And if I can help you guys in any way get into corporate aviation and become a private jet pilot, let me know how I can help you in the description, in the comments below. Like this video, subscribe, and stay tuned. I've got more content coming. And follow me on Instagram, WorldwideHube is my Instagram. I'd like to help you guys in any way possible. I love giving back. You might have seen my ATP flight school videos. I would recommend ATP flight school. If you can find a freelance flight instructor or a cheaper, more creative way to get your ratings quickly, then do that. I would recommend that over ATP, but ATP is a great option. So thank you guys. Like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.